be up standing for the entrance of the bride. Right. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. We're going to sing our first song hymn, Come to a Wedding. Please, will you all sit apart from the four at the front? In the presence of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we have come together to witness the marriage of Colin and Helen, to pray for God's blessing on them, to share their joy, and to celebrate their love. Marriage is a gift of God in creation through which husband and wife may know the grace of God. It is given so that as man and woman grow together in love and trust, they shall be united with each other in heart, body, and mind, as Christ is united with his bride, the church. The gift of marriage brings husband and wife together in the delight and tenderness of sexual union and joyful commitment to the end of their lives. Marriage is a way of life made holy by God and blessed by the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ. With those celebrating a wedding at Cana in Galilee. Marriage is a sign of unity and loyalty, which all should uphold and honor. It enriches society and strengthens community. No one should enter into it lightly or selfishly, but reverently and responsibly in the sight of Almighty God. Colin and Helen are now to enter this way of life. They will each give their consent to the other and make solemn vows, and in token of this, they will give and receive a ring. We pray with them that the Holy Spirit will guide and strengthen them, that they may fulfill God's purposes for the whole of their earthly life together. First, I am required to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. Who brings this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
So if you take Colin, Helen's hand and pass it to Colin, you are giving her away. Thank you. And you can now sit down. Colin and Helen, the vows you are about to take are to be made in the presence of God, who's judge of all and knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. Now, would you like to face each other and come nearer to the microphone? We put that there so that your answers can be caught on film. Colin, will you take Helen to be your wife?
I will.
Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Helen, will you take Colin to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
And will you, the families and friends of Colin and Helen, support and uphold them in their marriage, now and in the years to come?
We will.
So now let's pray the marriage prayer. God our Father, from the beginning you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessings on Colin and Helen, that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and commitment to each other. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Now, Colin and Helen, I invite you to join hands and make your vows in the presence of God and his people.
Yeah.
Colin, I, Colin, take you, Helen.
I, Colin, take you, Helen.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For rich or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God, I make this vow. in the presence of God,
I make this man.
I make this vow. Helen. I, Helen, take you, Colin.
I, Helen, take you, Colin.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
Right, loose hands. And if I could have the ring, please. Thank you. Thank you. Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let this ring be to Colin and Helen a symbol of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Colin. You'd like to put it halfway up her finger, that's it, and hold it there. And say, Helen, I give you this ring.
Helen, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Now, push the ring right on. Hope it fits.
It's hot. Mm-hmm. Well done.
Okay. And Helen, you now say, I receive this ring.
I receive this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
With my body, I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
In the presence of God and before this congregation, Colin and Helen have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of a ring. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. Join your right hands. I'm going to wrap this round it. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Colin, you may kiss the bride. And now prayer of blessing on the marriage. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, for you have created joy and gladness, pleasure and delight, love, peace and fellowship. Pour out the abundance of your blessing upon Colin and Helen in their new life together. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts and a crown upon their heads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship. awake and asleep, in joy and in sorrow, in life and in death. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that banquet where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully grant you the riches of his grace, that you may please him, both in body and soul, and living together in faith and love, may receive the blessings of eternal life. Amen. Well, now we're going to stand and sing a hymn, and Colin and Helen will come and sit and face you all. Let's stand. Please sit down, and Matt and Claire, if you'd like to come up and read.
Okay, the reading is from Colossians 3, 12 to 17. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive one another for any grievances you have against somebody. Therefore, as the Lord forgave, you forgave. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. Let the peace of Christ, who rules in your hearts, since as members of one body you are called to peace, and be thankful. Let the message of Christ dwell among you richly as you teach, admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your hearts. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him.
Love. Love is a friendship that has caught fire. It is quiet understanding, mutual confidence, sharing and forgiving. It is loyalty through good and bad. It settles for less than perfection and makes allowances for human weaknesses. Love is content with the present. It hopes for the future and it doesn't brood over the past. It's the day in, day out chronicle of irritations, problems, compromises, small disappointments, big victories, and working towards common goals. If you have love in your life, it can make up for a great many things you lack. If you don't have it, no matter what else there is, it is not enough. So search for it, ask God for it, and share it.
Thank you, both of you. According to the TV presenter Les Dennis, three things reinforced the attitude of the bride as she entered the church. She saw the aisle of the church festooned with flowers. Her eyes were then fixed on the altar in the distance, beautifully and colourfully designed. And as she approached the groom, her eyes focused on the hymn board to her left. And she thought to herself privately as the couple came together, "I'll alter him." Both Colin and Helen have been married before, of course, and they know only too well that they can't alter each other. They can't change each other's habits around the toothpaste tube or anything else. And I think it's unlikely that they'd even want to try. They're marrying each other because they love each other as they are. But I like that anecdote. And I want to use each of those three words as an anchor for my message for Colin and Helen. Firstly, the aisle. Now, the aisle, of course, is the pathway into church. It's a bit wide at the moment because of our COVID restrictions and filming and so on. But in a very literal way, it's also the pathway into Colin and Helen's marriage. You both came down the aisle separately. You will return up the aisle as a married couple. In their marriage, church life and all that it stands for will be a very important element. They will be committed to God first and foremost because they are, as Paul put it in that reading from Colossians, God's chosen ones, holy and beloved. And then there's the altar. We call it a holy table, but lots of churches call it an altar, from where we offer the bread and wine in a Eucharist or a communion service, is the place symbolizing what Jesus did by dying on the cross for each of us. It is at the heart of the Christian faith, and it is therefore in a very real way at the heart of Colin and Helen's relationship. For the person who's truly sorry for what they've done, Jesus' death on the cross paves the way for forgiveness and a right relationship with God. In our reading from Colossians are the words, bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other, just as the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. Forgiveness is central to any relationship, and for a married couple, there will be many occasions where it's required. It goes hand in hand with the compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, patience, and love, which Paul also highlights in that passage. Where there is real forgiveness, there is peace. To know one is forgiven by God enables the peace of Christ to rule in our hearts, as Paul puts it. And to know that one's spouse has forgiven one's particular peccadilloes, both small and great, leads to peace in the relationship. And then there's the hymn, spelt, of course, H-Y-M-N, not H-I-M. Now, we don't do it here. We have screens and things instead. Many churches have a hymn board up with the hymn numbers portrayed so that the congregation can easily find them in their hymn books. This is a reference to worship, to singing praise to God together. And Paul says something about that too in the passage. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and with gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. Gratitude in our hearts. The attitude of thanksgiving is so important in marriage. A couple who are thankful for the little things in life, let alone the big things, will be a very happy couple, able to cope with the inevitable challenges that will come their way. Thankfulness can transform us as individuals too. To be glad and thankful that the glass is half full, rather than being miserable about it being half empty, is surely the secret of a joyful life. Thankfulness is an attitude of the will, of course, a determination to see the lovely things and be grateful for them, rather than focusing on the bad and the sad. And so Paul concludes this passage by saying, whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. And I'm sure that Colin and Helen will encourage each other to do this and will regularly express their gratitude to God in worship. Colin and Helen, your married life together is doubtless going to be full of joys and sorrows, troubles and wonderful moments. But those three words, aisle, altar, hymn, will hopefully help you to remember some fundamentals. Aisle, the way into church life and commitment to God with all that involves. Altar, the place where Christ forgives you and you therefore forgive each other. And hymn, the worship you offer to God together with thankful hearts. And now I'm going to invite Mike and Caroline to come and lead our prayers.
I have to say, this is like coming home, and what a privilege to be praying for our dear friends. I'm just so moved to be doing this, and it's so lovely to be back here at St. John's. Dear Lord, as Colin and Helen begin their lives together on this, their wedding day. We pray that their hearts will unite as one with you in their desire to make you the center. May this day be the start of something beautiful, a celebration unlike any other.
As they offer their vows to one another in the sight of God and others, give them a clear understanding of their commitment to each other. May their loyalty in marriage mirror your own love and faithfulness to all your children. Let them know that two are better than one, as they mutually invest in and depend on each other, but that the third strand of their marriage ties should always be you, Lord.
May their love be a circle that never ends. Lord, grow that loving relationship into one that is patient and kind, not boastful or proud, one that is unselfish and trusting, and a love that protects and perseveres through every season of life.
We pray you will give Colin and Helen unforgettable moments, unending dedication, and unselfish motives as they pledge their devotion to each other. In every way possible, make the life they build together a godly one, a life where hurts are healed with grace, a place where hearts are sealed with forgiveness, and a place where emotions feel safe when shared with honesty and gentleness. Keep their communications open with you and with each other as they make prayer a constant priority.
Lord, today and every day, let laughter echo in the halls of their hearts and their home. Let joy fill every room, and let the radiance of your face shine on them. Bless them and give them a gracious peace that passes all understanding. Light a fire of passion that prompts them to love you with all their heart, soul, and strength. Help Colin and Helen to bear each other's burdens, even as they cast their cares on your shoulders. May they always choose to see the best in each other, even in the worst of times.
May they visualize their marriage as more than just a bonding of two lives, but as two on a mission for you, Lord, a lighthouse of refuge, a welcome place for encouragement, and a testimony to your power and grace. Help them to cherish their wedding day as a sacred memorial and their union as a treasure to protect at all costs. Make it a reminder of hope that is lasting and faith that keeps on growing. Help them to believe that all things are possible through Christ, the one who began the good work in them.
Lord, on Colin and Helen's wedding day, may every word spoken and every precious moment remind them of the one who holds all things together and who makes all things good. Together as this couple stands side by side, hold them tightly and never let them go. Fill their hearts with unceasing gratitude. Be their vision, their strength, and their constant companion. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Right, well, we're nearly there. Time for our final hymn. And during this hymn, the wedding party would like to come round the table. And Joy, thank you, Joy, for all this playing. Joy will play for us while we do the signing of, not registers anymore, they're bits of paper under the new rules. But we'll sign them anyway and take the photos. So let's stand and sing. Great is thy faithfulness.
Thank you.
This very important piece of paper will shortly be on its way to Chelmsford Registry Office. If I don't lose it. Okay. Right, just a blessing for you all. God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side, and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Please stand for the bride and groom.